Today we will study about sorting in and sorting out process. The solubility of a protein depends upon the properties and distribution of polar groups, hydrophilic groups and non-polar hydrophobic groups in the molecule and the resulting dipole moment. The ionic polar groups of protein molecules interact both within the same molecule and with the surrounding molecules, and they tend to form ion aggregates and oppose their solubility. And this interaction between protein charged groups is decreased in pure water because the polar water interact with the polar groups of proteins that tend to increase the solubility. Okay, that means the solute-solute interaction decreases and solute-solute-solvent interaction increases when we dissolve in pure water. Okay, so it is seen that the solubility of a protein increases upon the addition of low salt concentration. By conducting a series of investigation on serum globulins, Mellenbach was able to anticipate principle of ionic strength formulated by Lewis and Rendall in 1921. And they found that at a low salt concentration, the increase in the logarithm of solubility is directly proportional to the ionic strength, and we can calculate the molar ionic strength by this formula, where mu, that is molar ionic strength, is equal to under root summation ni zi, where mu denotes the ionic strength and denotes the molar concentration of and zi denotes the valency of all the ions in solution. In a small amount, the salt concentration act as a shield for each protein molecule and prevent them from attracting and interacting with each other so that they cannot form aggregates and not precipitate out. And this phenomenon of keeping the protein molecules separated in a solution by addition of a small quantity of salt is called salting in. Now, just opposite of it, that is at very high concentration of very soluble salt, such as ammonium sulfate, sodium sulfate and phosphate buffer, proteins are salted out in solution, that means they precipitate out in solution. Now we will see how this happens. Actually, salting out is due to the decrease in the activity of water, which diminishes the solubilizing interaction between water and the protein polar groups. The solubility as of many proteins at high salt concentration decreases logarithmically as the salt concentration increases. You can see here the formula, log s is equal to beta minus KSW, where W is the ionic strength of the salt solution. Beta is equal to the solubility of the protein in pure water, and KS is the salting out constant. The value of KS vary with the protein and salt. The salting out effect is primarily a result of the competition between the added salt ions and the other dissolved solutes for molecule of solvents. Okay, as the salt concentration increases, freely available water molecules that can solvate the ions become scarce, and at this stage those water molecules that have been forced in contact with the hydrophobic R groups on the surface of the protein are the next most freely available water molecules and leave the hydrophobic patches exposed on protein surface. And these hydrophobic patches cause proteins to interact and to aggregate by hydrophobic interaction, resulting in precipitation. And since different proteins precipitating at different salt concentration, the sorting out is the basis of the most commonly used protein purification procedure. Adjusting the salt concentration in a solution containing a mixture of proteins just below the precipitation point of protein to be purified eliminates many unwanted proteins, and we can purify the proteins like this. Apart from ammonium sulfate, we can also use organic solvents to precipitate out the proteins, but here apart from but in that case, hydrophobic interaction is not responsible for protein aggregation, whereas polar-polar interaction are responsible for the aggregation of protein.